It's a military family, born in England.
Really? Wow.
Yeah.
So I kept you on even a little longer, and, you know, you learn more. But, they, yeah, you're traveling around a lot and shit.
Yeah.
As a kid, yeah, that's rough. I mean, where I live now is the longest I ever lived in one place, and it's about 15 years, so.
You must like it.
Yeah, it's weird, though, because I just, honestly, it's the neighborhood went down a little bit. I just don't feel like packing my shit.
Yeah.
But, it's not bad, but, you know, were you in the music business while you were in L.A. or?
Yeah, that's what I moved out there for. I got a job working at a recording studio called NRG.
Oh, cool. Yeah, I'm familiar.
When I got there, I mean, the bands that went there were Cold Chamber was doing chamber music at the time. 311 was in there. Orgy was doing their second record. Yeah, it was a whole lot going on there at the time. Like, and it was like 98. Yeah, 98 when I moved there.
So
I did that for a long time, then I got into doing live sound.
So that's, I guess, where the quality recording side of the CD comes in.
Oh, I learned a lot.
Yeah, because, I mean, that's one of the things I noticed right away. That's the first thing I notice about a lot of bands is the quality. And when you sent the song, and I was like, God damn, man, these cold cock bands just know what they're doing. And there's so many good bands out there. It's hard to choose who to play every week. And it's like, man, I want to play every single song, but I don't always have that much time to, you know, when I run into an hour interview, I only have so much time I can play music because I still have to do other segments and shit. But yeah. It's like, man, it's just, if I could have had this quality back when I was recording CDs, it would have been amazing. The process was so involved to make it good. And, you know, you're working with DAT tapes and shit, you know.
Oh, but I still got my old D88 sitting in there that will never get used again, but I won't throw it away.
Right. I hear you. I just
got the lights on.
That's funny. But, you know, I've recorded on the modern side too, but I mean, I still feel, you know, I kind of like the old way a little better. It sounds a little warmer, but now that it's progressed so much over the past 10 years, I mean, you can make anything sound like anything, so it really doesn't matter.
Yeah, technology has definitely helped an awful lot.
It helps shitty bands become tighter, but I mean, it still don't help. That, you know, you still got to be able to write a song. It's like baseball player taking steroids. Okay, you could take the steroids and have more power, but you still have to be able to play the game. So just because you put out a quality recording don't mean the songs are well written, but.
Now, I've heard some amazing sounding records that I couldn't get into a single song, but, you know,
right.
They sound
right. Right, exactly. So it's just, you know, it's just one of those things. But here we go. I'm going to play Chemical Coma by Machines on Blast. You're listening to Jay Stone. That was Evan from Machines on Blast. I appreciate you calling in. Here's Chemical Coma, Jay Stone, live from rockmetaltalk.com.
Can I be the truth? beyond your lies can I be?
Listening to the Jay Stone Show at rockmetaltalk.com.